So just a quick side note, guys. In that video there, I was in New South Wales, in Eden to be exact, and I was going for a spearfish, but as you can tell in the video, all the stuff I was saying you can't hear. It was way too windy. So basically all I'm saying is I'm gonna try to find a sheltered spot along the shoreline. So we'll get back to the video. Yeah, no, so it was all pretty windy along that shoreline, so I've gone back to the car. I'm gonna try and drive along the shoreline for a bit, see if I can find something a bit more sheltered.
This spot looks heaps better.
Right, yeah, let's do this. Got the gun, let's get some fish. Anyone home? So in sort of thick bush like this, my usual technique is sort of make your way as quickly and easily to sort of the edge of the bush as possible, like on the top of the cliffs. And you can sort of follow the bush cliff edge to a safe place to get to the water. Because if you just try and bush bash straight to where you want to go, sometimes you get stuck in some pretty gnarly stuff. I'm just going to walk through this stuff because it's pretty reasonably clear compared to what it is over there. And then I'll stroll along the top of the cliff where hopefully there's a bit less trees and I'll find somewhere to get down. So I found a bit of clearer scrub now, as you can see, and I reckon I should be able to get down to the water just down there, I reckon. It looks quite nice, I'm pretty excited. This spot looks awesome. I'm actually so excited to get in. Like the water, so clear. Like, oh, Tassie winter's been pretty murky in the river areas, so I'm so excited. Fingers crossed, there are some fish. Rightio, I'm pretty toasty, so I'll jump in. Just a quick side note, I am diving alone, but it's not something that I recommend or reckon anyone should really ever do, but I've got no friends, so I sort of have to, but when you are diving alone, if you really need to, stay well within your comfort zone. For example, if this is just like kicking on the surface level of comfort, this is the edge of my comfort zone. So there's my comfort zone. When I dive alone, I dive about within this range. I don't do anything even close to being slightly sketchy. Like I'll literally only probably dive maximum of 5 meters by myself. And I won't stay under for very long at all. It's not worth blacking out and dying just to dive a little bit deeper, I don't think. So keep really, really safe when you're diving alone. Could you be loved? Could you be loved? Could you be loved? Well, done the dive. I reckon it was reasonably successful. I got a black drummer. It was a black drummer. And I also got some sort of cod. I just remember reading on the New South Wales fishing app that they're quite a good eating fish if you don't mind gutting through heaps and heaps of slime. So I was like, might as well take him. So I've got two nice fish for dinner. So yeah, I'm pretty happy. There they are. So the cod's a pretty good sized fish and the black drummer's also a good size. So I'm definitely not gonna starve today, which is always nice. But I did lose three black drummer before I got this one, which is quite annoying. I think my spear must be really blunt or something. I'll find out when I edit the footage. But yeah, it was a bit frustrating, but still, good feed. See you guys back at wherever I can find to clean the fish and eat them.
Just a quick update, guys, from the walk back. I almost thought I stepped on a snake, but I think it's just a snake skin. Yeah, look at that. It's really long. It starts there, goes all the way through the bushes, and keeps going, and it finishes over there. So it's like a 2 meter long snake. It's massive. But yeah, hopefully I don't run into the actual snake out while I'm walking. That would be a bit annoying.
There are my two fish, the cod and the black drummer thing. I'll give them a clean and see how they turn out.
There's the clean fish, guys. That there's the black drummer. That's the piece of cod, or as I just found out, they're called wirra. Some local has given me some advice that they're not very good eating and not to eat it. So I kept one big fillet off it because I'm kind of curious and I'm quite hungry. But I've kept all the black drummer, but I cut up the rest of the wirra and fed it to these pelicans. But I don't think it went around too well because they're still really hungry and have come back to ask for more. So I probably shouldn't have fed them because now they're pests. But that's all right. At least the rest of the fish didn't go to waste. So now I'm going to go to the public barbecue and cook them up. See you guys there.
Rightio, I'm now at the barbecue. Looking a pretty simple recipe, just a bit of flour, garlic, salt and chilli powder. And I'll coat the fish in that and whack them on the barbie. Should be pretty good.
I'm actually a genius. Just discovered if you use one of your pieces of fish to lock up the hole in the public barbecue, you can shallow fry it. How good.
Rightio, guys, there's my plate of fish.
This one here is the wirra, which apparently is really bad eating, but it looks like quite a firm flaky white fish, so I'll give that a try now and see how it's like.
Nothing wrong with it, that's fine. That's good.
Yum, got a good feed. Cheers for watching, guys, like and subscribe.